What type of electrical panels are good candidates for solar, and what are bad candidates for solar? Is a question I asked John Shaw, project engineer for Bella Energy.
I mean, long story short, there are panels out there that through grandfather clause, you know, if any contractor came in and did any electrical work, that electrical work could not pass because of the fact that there's a panel there. I mean, there's a particular brand that was in lawsuits and stuff like that. So, but that's a little bit too nitpicky. I mean, the things we're looking for when I do a site visit is 100 amp service. 100 amp main service will limit the size of back feed breaker that we can use to feed the house. There's other ways to integrate a system into the house with line side taps, which can be done in a couple different locations. But essentially we're looking for 150 plus amp service with empty breaker spaces, at least two.
Okay.
That's gonna be the best scenario. We certainly can get around anything and everything we run into, but it's a question of how much additional time, whether or not you need a full service upgrade, whether or not you need to ask Excel for a larger service, things like that. The easiest way to integrate a system into your home is to do what's called a backfeed breaker onto your service panel, which other people call a breaker box. If there are a couple of empty spaces, we essentially put in a special type of breaker that instead of drawing power and sending it to your living room, actually takes power from the PV system and puts it onto the bus bars, which then is just another source of electrons onto those bus bars for all of the other breakers to pull from. But we're limited in the size of breaker we can put in there by the overall service. So for example, if you had 100 amp service, the biggest breaker we could use to backfeed the system would be a 20 amp breaker. And that would mean that you could probably only do about a 3 kilowatt system, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, three sounds about right. I'd have to do the math to figure it out because I don't have it in my head, but there are some other ways to get around it too. It's actually, what the code actually says is that if it's 100 amp service, usually that means you have 100 amp bus bar in your service panel and 100 amp main disconnect. And what it's actually saying is that you can only feed the bus bar with 120% of its rating. So it's fed by the main breaker by 100% usually of its main rating, and you can add 20%. But if the main breaker happens to be an 80 amp breaker on a 100 amp bus bar, then that's another 40 amps you could add. Or you can sometimes change out that main breaker. Usually it's easier just to go to a line side tap than to get involved in changing out main breakers. But, you know, there are a lot of ways basically to do it.